in chapter number 12, electricity, we go through the index question. Question is, calculate the number of electrons constituting one coulomb of charge. We already find the formula to define number of charge in last session. I is equal to the formula of current is I is equal to Q upon T. But here we know the when we find the number of electrons, we take Q is equal to Ne. The formula Q is equal to Ne we take when we find the number of electrons. Here we calculate the number of electrons, so we use Q is equal to Ne. We already know the here one formula is given, one coulomb. Calculate the number of electrons constituting one coulomb of charge. But we already know the charge of electron is small e is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Here we ignore minus sign and in example we simply take 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And Q is equal to given 1 coulomb. If the charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to 19, so why find the charge Q in is equal to 1 coulomb and we find the number of electrons here. So we in the formula Q is equal to Ne, we take the subject of Ne and so Q and in upon small e. We use formula Q is equal to Ne, we make the subject of small n, so n is equal to Q. Here e is multiplication, so it is in division. Q is equal to 1 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Calculate the value and we put 1 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to 19. Here 19 is in division, it is minus. So when it is in multiplication, it can be plus. 1 upon 1.6 is equal to 0.265 into 10 raised to 19. Here we put something small value, so we put 6.25 into 10 raised to 18 coulomb. So we find number of electron is 6.25 into 10 raised to 18 coulomb. Another question is to find the SI unit of volt. At SI unit of ampere, we already find the ampere in last session. So we can take it again. Let's through another equation, another point. It is called electric potential. In bringing an electric charge small q from infinity to a point capital P in the electric field of a charge capital Q, work has to be done against the electric force excited by the Q on Q, capital Q on small q. Let's see, in simply, we have the charge small q and we have the charge capital Q. If we take Q from small q from capital Q in the point P, so we give the force for it to bring out in small q to capital Q. The work done in bringing a unit of positive charge from infinity to a particular point in the electric field, but the forces against the electrostatic force due to electric field is called the electric potential. Let's repeat. The work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity. We don't know the place. If the point is infinity, infinity to a particular point in the electric field against the electrostatic force due to the electric field is called electric potential. Electric potential, the formula is here we write electric potential. Electric potential is equal to work done, the symbol of work is capital W, the charge is here small q. So the work done is capital W upon electric charge small q. We know the formula of electric potential is capital V. Capital V is equal to W upon q. When we make the subject capital W, so capital W is equal to V into Q. Here the SI unit of electric potential is, the SI unit of work is joule and Q is coulomb. So the SI unit of electric potential is joule per coulomb. It is called volt. Here one thing notice is that the symbol of electric potential is capital V and the SI unit of electric potential is capital V. Alexandro Volta, scientist, find the SI unit of electric potential volt. To rememberize them and to rememberize it, him, we take the potential, we take the symbol capital V and take the SI unit volt. To rememberize the scientist Alexandro Volta. Here we discuss about to infinity place, but in practically, in practical use, we take, if we take two points, suppose point A and point B, the work done in bringing a unit positive charge from point B to point A, B particular point, here the particular point B, from B to A, from B to A, we give the electric force against the electrostatic force due to the electric field. So here the formula is taken, potential difference at final point P minus potential difference at initial point A is equal to W upon Q. If the potential difference at final point B is VB and the potential difference at initial point A is equal to VA. So the formula is VB minus VA is equal to W upon Q. V is equal to W upon capital Q. SI unit is volt or joule per coulomb as we take here. The definition of volt is if the potential difference between two points is an electric field is 1 volt, and the work done is 1 joule, of the work is done to move a charge 1 coulomb. Work done is 1 joule and the charge is 1 coulomb from one point to another. So 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per 1 coulomb. Here we take the definition of 1 volt. So 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per 1 coulomb. We measure the electric potential difference with the instrument voltmeter. Voltmeter is always connected in high resistance. Voltmeter take high resistance power and it is always connected within the parallel combination. Two things can be important: voltmeter to measure electric potential different, we use instrument voltmeter. To find the electric current, we use the instrument ampere. Ampere always connected in low resistance, while voltmeter is connected in high resistance. Ampere always connected with the series combination, while voltmeter is always connected in parallel combination. In this chapter, we already study in detail about series combination and parallel combination. Let's go through the in-text question. When the electric current can be which instrument can be conduct the electric current? A electric cell, here the word is cell, or battery can conduct the electric current. The second is, what is the mean by 1 volt? Here we already write about the 1 volt. So we don't write again, but we learn it by heart. What is mean by 1 volt? If potential difference between two points A and B is an electric field is 1 volt. If 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb from one point to another, it will be called 1 volt. 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per 1 coulomb. How much energy is given in each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery? Here the example will be given. So V is equal to 6 volt and we find the what will be the work. How much energy is given in each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery? Here the volt can be given and the charge will be 1 coulomb. So we take the formula W is equal to first we take V is equal to W upon Q, but here we find energy, so we make a subject W. W is equal to V into Q. Here V is 6, Q is 1, so here the answer is 6 joule. Let's take again. If the electric current is 0.5 passing through in the time of 10 minutes, what will be the charge? Electric charge is find out. So first we take I is equal to 0.5 ampere, the time is 10 minute, and we find the electric charge Q is equal to how much. But if we know the in formula I is equal to Q upon T, Q is a coulomb and small t, SI unit of small t is second. So we can't take directly 10 minute. First we convert 10 minute into second. So here t is equal to 10 minute and we convert into second 10 into 60. So is equal to 600 second. Then we use the formula I is equal to Q upon T. Here we make a subject Q. Q is equal to I into T. I is equal to 0.5, so we write 5 upon 10 and T is 600. So here we write I is equal to 0.3 and here we take, so 10 is cancelled and here we take 300, 5, 6 are 30 and 0. So Q is equal to 300 coulomb. Then we find another. If the potential difference is between two points is 12 volt and the charge is 2 coulomb, how much energy we'll find? Again, we use the formula of V is equal to W upon Q. Make a subject W, V into Q. V is equal to 12 volt, Q is equal to 2 coulomb, so here is equal to 24 joule. In this chapter we have the examples for 2 or 3 marks, so it cannot be hard. First we remember the formula and then apply in the calculation. So you have to write all the formulas in the column. If you write in the foolscap, you write all the formulas in the column and then calculate. So you have to remember it for long time. Let's see what is the circuit diagram. A schematic diagram relative position and connections of various circuit components represented by their electrical symbols. Here one thing is not is important. Let's repeat. A schematic diagram relative positions and connection of various circuit components represented by their electrical symbols is called circuit diagram. Here we draw the labeled circuit diagram. Here we take a bulb, emitter, a plug key, or you called it switch. battery, electric current is pass. Electric current is connected them with the circuit. We use symbols in the circuit. So this is a symbol of bulb, emitter, switch and battery. In question we draw the label diagram of use with the bulb, emitter, battery, close key. So we draw this type of diagram. In question you have to ask which type of components you have to draw. Label diagram of a electric current is given in this diagram. Battery, electric bulb, emitter and plug key close is given. Here the point is given in bracket. It will be so the key is close and the point not given, the key is open. And the way of the electric current, it is conventional because it is going through the plus sign to minus sign, conventional current. In question the conventional current will be asked, so we give the way of conventional current. What have to question will be asked in the exam, you have to write the answer according to question. If the electric current will be asked, we write the arrows from minus to plus. Here we draw the tables with some components, symbols of some components with their diagrams. You have to draw the table for the symbols and components. Here first we take the components and then give the symbols. The table will be most important in the question and answer and also in the calculation for the examples. So you have to draw the table and according to your table you have to remember all the signs for components. An electric cell, the big line is plus, small is minus. A battery or a combination of cell, here we give one cell, so the combination of cell we write 2, 2, 3 and it is called battery. Here we give the symbol of battery. A plug key or a switch is open. Open is we don't put dot in the bracket, but a plug key or switch is close, we put dot in bracket. If two wire are joined, let's try draw with this and to make point between the joining of two wire. Wires closing without join, crossing, sorry. Wires crossing without join, we put the inverted C for it. Electric bulb, we draw here electric bulb, or in electric bulb you have to draw like this. Shining of bulb. Resistance or resistor, symbol capital R, you have to draw like this. Component capital R, symbol is this. Variable resistance or rheostat, it is drawn in this way and either it is in this way. Emitter, capital A. voltmeter, capital V. The symbols are important in examples and in question and answer. You must have to draw the table for it and remember for the signs. Here, what is the circuit diagram? Labeled circuit diagram with given. In question, we given bulb, emitter, closed plug key and battery and show the path of conventional current. So we have to represent emitter, key, battery and bulb. In question what I have to ask, you have to draw according to question and we give the path of conventional current and some and symbols for some components with that diagram. First, here we take the components and give them symbol according to components.